Well, Xbox is a company that we've talked a lot about on this channel, and sometimes I like to bring up their mixed messaging, because a lot of times I feel like the message kind of gets lost with Xbox stuff. They'll do a lot of positive things, and people will be happy, and it'll seem like it's going one way, but then you'll have an interview with Phil Spencer or Matt Booty, who we call Matt Ass on this channel, and then things just kind of take a spin on their head, like a little topsy-turvy top thing that you had when you were a little kid, because little kids used to be amazed by the simplest thing. Today we're going to be talking about Game Pass, though, because people are pissed because that Game Pass price hike is indeed here. And, you know, it's not even necessarily the price hike. It's the changing of things that I think people are most pissed off about. Because remember, PlayStation went crazy with a price hike on their online services, and people were pissed about that. And this price hike, in comparison, really isn't that much, but it's just the confusion that comes with it, because nothing is simple when it comes to Xbox. So, this just happened late last night. I'm filming it at night, and we're talking about it today. Game Pass updates announced July 2024. Starting July 10th, the following updates to Xbox Game Pass will take effect. Price changes will go into effect for new members for Xbox Game Pass Ultimate, Xbox Game Pass Core, and PC Game Pass. Game Pass for console will no longer be available for new members. Members who are already subscribed to Game Pass for console and have automatic payment renewal enabled will be able to continue to enjoy their membership. Also, a new Game Pass option, Xbox Game Pass Standard, will be becoming available in the coming months. These changes will enable us to bring members more value and more great games to Game Pass. So, you know, when you have a lengthy FAQ to explain the changes that you're doing, things are going to be getting very, very confusing. You see, Xbox Game Pass for console will no longer be available for new members. There's that mixed messaging again. Because when I hear that, and I'm someone who's pretty in tune, but when I hear that, I'm like, what does that mean? Like, you're getting rid of Game Pass for console? But no, they're just changing it. And there's going to be a new tier. And the new tier, even though these changes will enable us to bring members more value and more great games to Game Pass, you have a tier now that is missing one of Game Pass's biggest features. Oh, Xbox. So let's take a look at the FAQ. What's changing here? So, on July 10th, 2024, updated prices will take effect for new member subscriptions. Starting September 12th, 2024, the price of reoccurring charges will change for existing members. Select countries are excluded from this price update. Recurring billing will not change. New prices will take effect on the next reoccurring billing charge after September 12th of 2024. These changes also impact 1 month, 3 month, and 6 month subscriptions to Game Pass Core in Turkey, South Africa, and Argentina. Okay, whatever. So they're changing some stuff like that. Now here's where things start to get really weird. Changes to Xbox Game Pass for console. Starting on July 10th of 2024, Xbox Game Pass for console will not be available for new members. If you are currently enrolled in it, you're fine. You know, there's nothing to do there. If you change your automatic payment or your membership lapses, you no longer have access to it. You can stack things for 13 months. So Game Pass Standard is going to be $15, and they say that includes offering different prices and plans so players can find what works best for them. So when you look at what Game Pass Standard is, you know, it gives you hundreds of high-quality games to play on your console. It also features all the benefits of Game Pass Core, such as online console multiplayer and select member deals and discounts, including up to 50% off select games. Game Pass Standard will not include games released on day one. Excuse me? What? Isn't that the whole point of Game Pass? Is that if you get Game Pass, you get the games on day one, all those Xbox games, the upcoming Call of Duty? And we all knew that a price hike was probably coming. I don't think anyone's necessarily super surprised by that. I just think it's how they have, you know, they're trying to give value to the legacy owners of Xbox Game Pass, but they're kind of screwing over the new owners by making this new tier that people are going to see that $15 and be like, oh, okay, well, I'll get this. It's Game Pass standard. It should have everything else. Like, what's the difference between this and Ultimate, which, of course, we'll read about in just a minute, because whenever you need a lengthy FAQ, you know you're making the right choice here. You know you're making the right decision. So, yes, Game Pass standard will not feature games released on day one. When do you get the games? Do you get the games? God, Xbox, what is wrong with you? How is Game Pass Standard different from Game Pass Ultimate? Game Pass Standard includes hundreds of high-quality games, online, console multiplayer, and select member deals. In addition to having all the benefits in Game Pass Standard, Ultimate also includes Day 1 titles, specific entries to the Game Pass Ultimate library, access to EA Play, xCloud Gaming, perks, quests, and discounts in the Game Pass library. So, do you not get xCloud anymore with Game Pass Standard? Because to me, it sounds like you're not getting it anymore. It's now, you know, it says in addition to, this is going to be, you know, Xbox Cloud Gaming is only on Ultimate now. Like, obviously some of the wait times for it were a little bit ridiculous at times, but it seems like they got things better. How is Xbox Game Pass Standard different from Xbox Game Pass Core? It's not, but they did get rid of that that day one Game Pass games. This is so stupid. The fact that you have to do all of this sort of stuff and you have to change things and reword things, like, it's so ridiculous. It's so ridiculous. So here is the new pricing structure of what we are going to be seeing with Xbox Game Pass and all of the weird sort of things with it. So Xbox Game Pass Core, this is coming to us from Tom Warren from The Verge. The Verge has me blocked. Xbox Game Pass Core, $9.99 a month, no day one games. Okay. PC Game Pass, $11.99 a month, day one games. Xbox Game Pass for console, existing subscribers, $10.99 a month, day one games. Xbox Game Pass Standard for new subscribers only, $14.99, no day one games. So at this point, okay, well, let's just go. Xbox Game Pass Ultimate, $19.99 a month, day one games. This is what sticks out to me the most, though. Why the hell would I buy an Xbox to get Game Pass Standard that doesn't have day one games and costs $15 when I could get PC Game Pass on a computer for $11.99 a month and get the day one games? How is this additional value? Like, I don't get why companies just can't be upfront and honest about things. Be like, hey, you know what? We're expanding things, and this is why the price is going up. We see it time and time again, and people are always going to be upset over a price increase, and I understand why. Times are tough out there. People are struggling. But to me, it's not even necessarily the price increases, because obviously, you know, at the most, it's a couple dollars more a month. You know, not the biggest deal in the world as far as the actual dollar amount is concerned, but it's the mixed messaging. Adding this new tier of Game Pass Standard for $15 with no day one games. You always say play it day one with Game Pass. Now you're going to have to say, play a day one with Game Pass Ultimate, because screw the Game Pass Standard people. And I guess, you know, screw the Game Pass Core people. But if you are an Xbox Game Pass console member for an existing thing, or you have PC Game Pass, you're good with that, because you are still... This is so dumb. This is so dumb. Stop overcomplicating things. You are not in the position right now, Xbox, to be overcomplicating things and pissing people off. You're not. You haven't been in a position to do that in quite a while. Sony can get away with that because people are still buying PlayStations. Nintendo can get away with it because people are going to buy Nintendo products regardless. They're all hyped for Donkey Kong Country Returns HD for $60, the third time this game has been released. It blows my mind. But Xbox does not have that luxury. You are not in the driver's seat. You are in the back seat. Probably passed out half asleep because you keep making strange decisions. And here's just another example of it. I mean, obviously, I'm going to keep my Game Pass because I'm a legacy member. But if you're trying to increase Game Pass subscribers, how is taking away things going to do that? I think that's the simplest question in the world. How is taking away features of Game Pass and making new tiers with less features going to look attractive to people? It's not. I don't see how it will be. So let me know in the comments section down below. What do you think of this? I'm sure there'll be some people that decide to cancel their Xbox Game Pass subscription, and this could end up biting them in the ass. Like, maybe people have been looking for a reason to stop, you know, spending money on Game Pass every month, and I could see a lot of people potentially not renewing things, even though they are in at that legacy price point, just because of the fact that, like, you're being threatened, like, oh, you can get this special price point now that you've had before, but if you cancel, or if you miss a payment, well, we're jacking up that price. Like, it's so dumb. It's so dumb. And as always, guys, thank you for checking out this video. If you are new to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button, like, comment, and share. Hit the bell as well. And as always, I'll catch you guys on the next video. Later.